if nothing else, the good sense of me. Plus two. Last one. Hold it. Reach it.
Last one.
you can reach it through the inner heels. Right, so again, getting just a little focus. Let's go 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hold. I'm just gonna reposition myself so I'm still in the frame. All right, squeezy, squeezy, hands off to your side. I'm gonna take it up and over. I'm gonna squeeze. 4, 3, 2, 1. Bring it through center, and I lift. My feet, by the way, do not change their relationship, meaning they stay in the same plane the whole time. And I'm squeezing, right? Bring it down. Where am I squeezing from? Inner thighs. Lower belly. Squeeze. Squeeze. 2, 1. Bring it center. Reset. Open over. And squeeze. 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 Bring it center. One more time like that. Take it up and over. Shoulders stay down. Squeeze. Pull your low belly in and squeeze. Let's go 3, 2, 1, through center, take it up and over, squeeze, squeeze, 3, 2, 1, bring it center, pause, take a respite, that's important. From here, I'm going to keep my knees bent, still using my inner thighs. Ooh, those inner thighs are talking. So from here, same thing, my knees are not going to change their relationship to one another. I go up and over, I extend my legs, and I bend. I squeeze heel in line with heel, and bend. Squeeze, squeeze. Last 2, and 2. Last 1, last 1. Bring it up. Take it up and over, squeeze, straighten. Squeeze, bend, all from that low belly. Nice deep rotation that is with control. Let's go 2, and 1. Bring it in, set it down, take your knees side to side. So nice. Get that pillow out of here. We're gonna do this. So I just discovered this, even though it's absurd, it's not like it's new, but it's new to me. So here we go. All right, hands behind the head. The premise is I'm gonna be twisting and pulling in my opposite knee, yeah? And then I'm pressing out. And I exhale, and curl, and I press up. If you want, you can have your hands in prayer. It makes it a little more manageable, right? So here we go. Last time in our practice round, because what happens is as I come down, the other leg comes up. I'm gonna take my hands toward, like a sack of potatoes, towards that side. And I come up and twist, and down and twist. Up. And it helps if you have gliders and you're on the hardwood floor, unlike baking on a yoga mat on dirty tile. It's not that dirty. It's not that clean, but it's not that dirty. Let's get a couple more. Really sucking it. So I have to go back to working part-time in just a couple days. And it's almost as if my taste buds knew, and they were like, you know what? Let's start finding salt and vinegar chips real tasty right now. Because the past 2 days, I've become like a munch monster. It's just awful. It'd be one thing if I was eating healthy and then supplementing my healthy diet with popcorn loaded with salt and vinegar chips. Can't say that I am. Can't say that I am. Let's go with 2 more. Last have the Miss America sash, but maybe that's just my vanity. Other people call us wood choppers. Mine's not as violent. I'm much more of a pacifist. But who's judging? Let's go five more. I want you to feel that pulling in and up. It's really using your legs like you still have springs, right? So you're stepping on the gas and the brake and the gas and the brake. You're in gridlock. Stop and go, stop and go. Two more. Mm-hmm. Last one. Good. All right, for this one, you need your pillow. My husband hates these and has now insisted that these are the pillows I use for fitness classes and not the nice ones. I happen to think they're nice. I disagree with his taste, but that's okay. That's a neither here nor there. All right, I'm going to have my pillow. I'm going to push it up, take it back, reach it back, and push. I guess it's toss. It's not quite a push. Press. And down. And press. So if you've been to my classes the past couple days, we've been doing a lot of these. Can't get enough. I like it because it's so much of my middle abdominals, and I get that connection between my right arm to my right leg, and vice versa, and then right shoulder to left pelvic girdle. Let's go three more. We're going to do plank after this, so things look more. Last one. Actually, I lied. Just tiny pluses. Tiny toss. Tiny toss. Feel four, three, two, one, and done. Flip it over. So let's talk about our plank. I'm going to have my thumbs in line with the nipple, right, which I say ad nauseum. But then I tuck my toes and I reach myself forward. And around and reach. And around and reach. Round and reach. As you're rounding, it's kind of like I want to imagine I'm going to like bike, right? Like my legs are just going to go wee, 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 wee. Right? That's how much I want to feel carved into my core. Let's go for four. Flex your heels back. For three. Try dropping your head when you round. It might make it more effective. Ab exercise. Last two. Last one. Lower your knees down. Rest back child's pose. Huh. Big, nice deep breaths. Maybe you want to take your head side to side. Okay. And let's come on up. Let's take this pillow. I may have bitten up more than I can chew with the size and width of this pillow. But not its panache. Here we go. All right. Oh, that's fun. Take it behind your leg. I'm giving it a squeeze. I'm going to come down onto my forearms because that's going to give me more lift. If that hurts your shoulders or your chest, you take a wide stance, whatever you need to do. So I'm just going to squeeze and lift. The old squeeze and lift. And immediately, I have a cramp in my hamstring. Fun times. Squeeze, squeeze. And I'm trying to direct this straight into the belly of my hamstring and deep into my glutes. So if you're not sure, just give yourself a little slap on the ass and make sure that it's slapping you back. Let's go for four, three, two, hold it. Now, this is the height we always strive for. I come down and reach. Do not let your sits bone move. Your sitting bone stays exactly where it is. So perky ass. Perky booties. Last two. Good. Last one. Bring it all the way down. Remove the pillow. Come up. Load your leg. I'm going to tuck my back toes. I'm going to drive up. And come down. So now that leg has the load and I'm lifting and lowering. So I'm still thinking that muscle that glute is active, but it's for a different purpose, right? Let's go four, three, last two. It gets better in this one. Take it down, reset. Bend into that knee. Take your back leg, or the same leg, right? So you're staying on that working leg. I come forward, take my leg, down and up. So let's talk about it. We went from a dynamic movement without load to dynamic, but with a lot of load. Now we're static, total load, total load. If you want to do a little corresponding shoulder work, mid-back work, right? The world is your fitness oyster. Let's go three more. Last two. Last one. And up. Shaky, shake. Eggs and bake. From here. So if you don't like the cardio, you're just down. If you do like the cardio, you're down and you hop and you hop. Good, keep it going. 30 seconds, wherever you are, whatever you're doing. Maybe you're like, I hate that, I just want to run or do some jumping jacks. Girlfriend, boyfriend, that is for you. Last 15 seconds, shake it out, work it out, get breathless. Five. So excited for that next set in 3, 2, 1. All right, here we go. Should have got something smaller. All right, wedge it on in there. Forearms down and squeeze and lift. Squeeze and lift. And again, if your forearms don't work, it doesn't feel good for you, you don't like that, take your hands. Maybe even take them a little wider, just so you can go lower. And you squeeze and you're lifting. I'm doing my best not to open up my hips, but I can't be sure. I mean, I can feel that I'm probably opening up my hips a little bit, so I'm just not gonna let that bother me. Think your collarbone's trajectory is forward and your sitting bone's trajectory is back. All the while you're squeezing the knee into the pillow, and that's causing the belly of the hamstring to ignite, and that glute. Well, there's several gluteal fibers, but, and again, if you're not sure, give it a little howdy doodle. We go for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. This is the height we're striving for. We come down. Reach and squeeze. Down. Reach and squeeze. Ribs are in. Neck is relaxed. Let's not borrow more tension. All the tension is in my abdominal. No. Let's go four more. Squeeze. And three. Last two. And here we go. One. Way quickly. Cast our pillow off to the side. Let's load it up. So, I want to put all the emphasis into this. So my foot's pressing down, back leg tucks, I come up and down. So my favorite apparatus is probably the Wunda chair, because it's so hard. I was saying this the other day, it's like the aunt who tells you you look terrible in your outfit, or says you could be better. It's just, you can't fake it. It's not there to coddle you. It's there to be like, bitch, do better. So, barring that, not having that apparatus, I try and do what I can. So, I'm pressing up. I'm coming down, loading it, trying to press again. Let's go two more. Like you're pushing down, and there's a pedal going through the floor. Reset. Bend your knee, hip is back, thigh is pulling back. back leg. I'm gonna come up and down. Trying not to move my sit bones. My chest stays open. My knee is not knocking into my big toe. And as a matter of fact, if it's my right foot down, I'm almost thinking that I'm pushing my right foot down and slightly clockwise, right? Just to get that wrap, that lateral wrap. And again, if you want to add that pull, let's go 3, 2, and 1. Step it up. Second set, cardio burst, or we're gonna take it down and up. And when you're coming down, really push up, squeeze your butt. Squeeze. Belly in and squeeze. Right, like it's such an exuberant act. Huzzah! Of course, if you're not, you're ha! And it's a lot more violent. 15 more seconds. Whatever it is you've chosen to do, do it with alacrity. Push. You go. You breathe. Last 10. Just gonna dance around while you guys work. Countdown 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right, guys. Let's take it on down. Pillow time with Megan. Soles of feet together. Heels together, balls of feet together. Hands one more time. I'm gonna hold it back. I'm gonna reach my arms back. I'm keeping my head lifted. You can lower it down, it's fine. I just like this feeling for my core because my hands are pressing and my feet are pushing. And I want to get that juxtaposition or opposite, right? So my hands are pushing up and my feet are pressing down. Here we go. Come, think of that press and push and come up. And then lower. I want to think that little press and that push, and then from those 2 points, I go up. Good. I'm going to talk to you guys as you do this. Once I give you guys that little push with the hands, press with the feet, and then both together. Good. Keep going. Here's where I talk. When you're coming down and your hands are pressing up, your ribs are pulling violently back into your body. As your feet press down, the hips are pulling violently into your body. So you've got this whole like funk, right? Like this sucking in and lengthening. When you're coming up, the glutes in the way that they are, the way that our legs are laterally rotated, right? Externally rotated, it helps protect the lumbar spine from over-rounding. But if you feel really uncomfortable, like if you have a shorter torso and really long legs, I don't want you to come up nearly as high, right? Just bring your arms down, right? Just get that sensation and bring your arms down. This actually would have been really good information to have shared at the very beginning of this exercise. So just rewind. Do this segment again, and then let's pretend I said it right from the start. Let's go 2 more. Awesome. All right, moving on. This time, a pillow comes under your pelvis. And this pillow's really squishy. So I'm actually gonna double it up. And now, oh yeah. Now, this is the business. This is what I want. So I'm pressing down. My pillow is now underneath my low back, and to the best of my ability, I want my tailbone to drop so that my hip points, my ASIS, they're smooth, right? I'm not like in this huge anterior tilt or posterior tuck, that the PS and the ASIS, pubic symphysis, anterior superior iliac spine, they're in the same plane, neutral pelvis. And so from here, I'm gonna imagine my low belly is smushing that pillow. And that action is gonna make my legs are unnecessary. So I'm gonna play with that premise. I'm gonna use my abs to lift my legs. Imagine you're a puppet on a string. One leg goes down, the other leg goes down. I wanna pause, exhale, recruit through my core, and then lower, pause, recruit through my core. Right, so again, my thighs, I want them to be relaxed. So again, the leg is the puppet, and your abs are the puppet strings. Good. Just a couple more. If you've done this a bajillion times, and you wanna go both legs down and both legs up, by all means, go for it. And some people have a really hard time getting out of their hip flexors. So it might feel good to squeeze your legs together. It might feel better to have a diamond shape. Whatever floats your boat. Let's go three more times, whatever variation you're doing, right? One at a time or both at a time. Two. And last one. All right. Hold it here. Supposing that you don't need to, my pillow kind of got away from me. There we go. All right. And we're back. So if you need to readjust, if you don't feel good, if you want to remove the pillow, that's fine. Just still think of the low belly. My arms come up. I'm going to squeeze my legs forward. Arms go back. Trying to juice a stone, right? So when you go forward and back, I want you to put all that weight and emphasis from your front body down. Do that three, last two, last one, and flip it and reverse it. All right, we're winding it down. We're just gonna do a little side work. So, top leg is forward. It's like, wait, right hand's yellow. Okay, top leg forward. I personally use my foot when I lift up and reach because that feels better for me because I get more hamstring than holding it here and lifting up. Now, you can say I'm lazy and that's debatable, but it starts to hurt my knee. I just don't have the architecture that can support that on a long-term basis. But you know what I can do? Put my foot down and work it out. So relax your foot for this part. Really make it your hip, right? So you're here. As a matter of fact, let's try that a couple times. So I'm squeezing, using my core. Squeeze. I want to imagine that my foot is on really paper thin glass, and I don't want to cut it. That's how relaxed my foot feels, or ideally. Let's go two more. Last one. And now let's add it. So I reach and down. Press up, press the foot, reach, bring it down. Release, relax the foot. Press. Transfer the weight. Reach. Lower it down. Release. Two more. Dead weight. Press. Push. Lift. Bring it back. Dead weight. Start from the bottom, just like Drake. Lift. Reach. Hold it here. Eight. Seven. Six, five, four, three, two, one. Lower it down. Hey. Chest is open. Shoulders are back. I'm going to, oh, I needed this guy. Something is missing. This is about to be really easy. The Thigh Master. I've seen on TV. I squeeze and squeeze. And as I squeeze, I want to trot up. Let's go for four. Hold it here. Lower on to the forearms, palms up. Second set. Squeeze. Squeeze.
Zip it in.
Four. Three. Two. Adding on. When this is my right hand, this guy, I'm gonna reach it up and squeeze. And I wanna feel, where am I having to compensate in my obliques? Four, three, two, one. Take it down. Center, four, three, two. Other side, hello. Squeeze. Find where you're feeling it. Four, three, two, one. Four, three, two, one.
Oh,
all right. Get out of there. Here we go. Second set, then we've got one more set of planks, and then we're done. So, blink and you'll miss it. Top leg is forward. Hand underneath your chest, or your shoulder rather. And remember, if you like it this way, do that. I've already explained, I like it this way. So again, if you are starting it with your foot down, relax that foot, no weight, very minimal weight. All right, I'm going to press up and down. I push and down. My shin presses down and out. Remember, push. Really get that shin down and towards your hand. Let's go for four. Use your obliques. Three. This leg is doing nothing. Last two. Last one. Now here we go. Leg is still doing nothing. I lift. Transfer the weight. Reach. Take it down, transfer the weight, dead weight. Lift, transfer weight. Bring it back, dead weight. Down. Let's go. Two more. Press, transfer weight. Take it down. Last time with feeling. Push. Reach, hold for 8, 7, 6, 5, 5, 4, 5, 3, 5, 2, 5, 1. Down, down. Child's pose. Final set of planks. You want to do push-ups? Go mad. I'm going to take that handy-dandy pillow to my knees. Again, thumbs are underneath. I'm going to go into my puking cat. Okay, so I squeeze and round. Come back to plank. Squeeze and round. Maybe even press your hands isometrically closer towards each other. Squeeze. Do that for three and two. Last one. Squeeze, 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 squeeze. That was good. Apropos. Cycle sound and release. Tabletop, cat cow, take a little side to side. Tuck your toes down, dog. Bend one and then the other. Right, pressing one foot and the opposite hand and then switching. Ah, so nice. One more time. And walk your feet pretty wide apart. Send your hips back. Press your feet down, elongate. And then pull your chest forward. Exhale, release. two more times. Pull your chest forward. Exhale, release. Last time. And let it go. Bend your knees, hands on the thighs. Pull out back. Bring it on up. High five. Great work. I will see you soon.